فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
And also the Prophet ﷺ combined those two in another hadith, which is اعملوا, work. اعملوا فكل ميسر لما خلق له. The Prophet ﷺ combined those two by saying اعملوا work. فكل ميسر. For everybody it is made easy for him. لما خلق له, that which he was created for him. Bukhari and Muslim both narrated it. نعم.
وإيماننا قول وفعل ونية من الخير والطاعة فيها نقيد.
Our iman is speech, action and intention of all good things. And for acts of obedience, the intention we stipulate.
The author here says, وَإِيمَانُنَا قَوْلٌ وَفِعْلٌ وَنِيَّةٌ. Now the author is going into the definition of al-Iman, حَدُّ الْإِيمَان. What's the definition, the ta'rif of Iman? And the author, rahimahullah, he defines that which Iman is and that which it consists of. Iman consists of three pillars. These are pillars of al-Iman. Without it, Iman will not stand. فَوَ قَوْلٌ, it is speech. وَفِعْلٌ, and it is action. وَنِيَّةٌ, and it is intention. So Iman is not قَوْل, a speech without no action. It is not قَوْلٌ بِلَا عَمَل. It is not speech with no action. And it is also action without no intention. So with these three, the Iman stands, which is Al-Qawl and Al-Amal. Waniyah, an intention. ولذلك الإمام الأوزاعي رحمه الله, he said, as Ibn Battah mentions in his kitab الإبانة الكبرى, he says, لا يستقيم الإيمان إلا بالقول. لا يستقيم الإيمان إلا بالقول. That a person's iman will not be steadfast. لا يستقيم الإيمان. Iman will not be there unless there is a speech. وَلَا يَسْتَقِيمُ الْإِيمَانُ, an iman will not be steadfast. وَالْقَوْلُ, and a person's قول will not be steadfast. إِلَّا بِالْعَمَلِ, unless he comes with actions. وَلَا يَسْتَقِيمُ الْإِيمَانُ وَالْقَوْلُ وَالْعَمَلُ, and a person's iman and his speech and his action will not be upright. إِلَّا بِنِيَّةِ, unless he comes with an intention. مُوَافَقَةٌ لِلسُّنَّةِ, in accordance to the sunnah. And Al-Awza'i goes on to say, وَكَانَ مَنْ مَضَىٰ مِنْ سَلَفِنَا, and those who have preceded us, who came before us, our pious predecessors, لَا يُفَرِّقُونَ بَيْنَ الْإِيمَانِ وَالْعَمَلِ, they will never distinguish between iman and actions. وَالْعَمَلُ مِنَ الْإِيمَانِ, actions are of the iman. وَالْإِيمَانُ مِنَ الْعَمَلِ, and iman is of the actions and the actions are of iman. وَإِنَّ الْإِيمَانُ اسْمٌ, iman is a term, يَجْمَعُ هَذِهِ الْأَدْيَانُ اسْمُهَا, it's a term that combines, gathers this religion's name. وَيُصَدِّقُهُ الْعَمَلُ, the iman of a person, your actions testify to if it's true or not. فَمَنْ آمَنَ بِلِسَانِهِ وَعَرَفَ بِقَلْبِهِ, anyone who testifies and believes with his tongue and he recognizes it through his heart. وَصَدَّقَ بِعَامَلِهِ, and then he is truthful with his actions. فَتِلْكَ, that is الْعُرْوَةُ الْوُثْقَ الَّتِي لَمْ فُصَامَ لَهَا, that person is holding onto a rope that will not disconnect. وَمَنْ قَالَ بِلِسَانِي, anyone who says the iman and testifies it on his tongue, وَلَمْ يَعْرِفْ بِقَلْبِهِ, but doesn't really know it with his heart, وَلَا يُصَدِّقُ بِعَمَلِهِ, and then he does not what? He doesn't back it up with his actions. لَمْ يُقْبَلْ مِنْهُ, it won't be accepted from him. وَكَانَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. And the day of judgment is going to be from the destroyed, lost ones. Sufyan al-Thawri said, as Ibn Battah mentions in his kitab al-Ibanat al-Kubra, كان الفقهاء يقولون, the jurists would say, أهل السنة, العلماء would say, لا يستقيم قول إلا بعمل, ولا يستقيم قول وعمل إلا بالنية, ولا يستقيم قول وعمل ونية إلا بموافقة السنة. The same thing that Al-Awza'i mentioned, which is a person's speech will not be steadfast except with an action, and his speech and action will not be steadfast unless with what? Unless with an intention. وَلَا يَسْتَقِيمُ, and his speech and actions and intention will not be steadfast إِلَّا بِمُوَافَقَةِ السُّنَّةِ, unless it's in accordance to the what? To the sunnah. Same is Al-Imam Al-Ajurri in Kitab al-Sharia, he says, he chapter a bab, a whole chapter in his Kitab al-Sharia, the first volume, page 274, he says, Babu, the chapter, Al-Qawlu, بأن الإيمان تصديق بالقلب وإقرار باللسان وعمل بالجوارح لا يكون مؤمنا إلا بأن تجتمع فيه هذه الخصال الثلاث. That iman is what? The testimony of the heart, the utterance of the tongue, the actions of the limb. And a person is not a believer unless he gathers all of those mentioned, all of those three that are mentioned, which is التصديق بالقلب وإقرار باللسان وعمل بالجوارح. And then he goes on to saying, اعلموا رحمنا الله وإياكم أن الذي عليه علماء المسلمين أن الإيمان واجب على جميع الخلق هو تصديق بالقلب وإقرار باللسان وعمل بالجوارح ثم اعلموا أنه لا تجزئ المعرفة بالقلب والتصديق إلا أن يكون معه الإيمان باللسان نطقا ولا تجزئ معرفة بالقلب والنطق باللسان حتى يكون عمل بالجوارح فإذا كملت فيه هذه الثلاث الخصال كان مؤمنا دل على ذلك القرآن والسنة وقول علماء المسلمين. He says, no, may Allah have mercy upon each and every one of you. That which the ulama of the Muslimin are upon and that which they believe is أن الإيمان واجب, that the iman is obligatory on every creation and everybody, and it is the iman that's obligatory and wajib on everybody is what? تصديق بالقلب, the belief of the heart. وإقرار باللسان, the affirmation of the tongue. وعمل بالجوارح, and the actions of the limb. ثم علموا, know what? That the knowing of the heart and the testimony of it will not be accepted and it will not be taken into consideration unless it is backed with what? The utterance of the tongue. And the knowing of the heart and the utterance of the tongue will not be accepted and taken into consideration unless it is backed up with amalul jawarih, the actions of the limb. If these three are found and they are present, the person kana mu'minan, he is a believer. Dalla ala dhalika, what has shown this is al-Qur'an, the Qur'an has shown this. Was-sunnah, and the sunnah has also shown this. Wa qawlu ulama'i al-muslimina, and the speech of the scholars of the Muslims have shown this. Wa qala shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he says, qala hanbal haddathana al-humaydiyu qal, وأخبرت أن الناس يقولون من قرأ بالصلاة والزكاة والصوم والحج ولم يفعل من ذلك شيئا حتى يموت ويصلي مستدبر القبلة حتى يموت فهو مؤمن ما لم يكن جاحدا إذا علم أن تركه في ذلك فيه إيمانه إذا كان مقرا بالفرائض واستقبال القبلة فقلت هذا الكفر الصراح وخلاف كتاب الله وسنة رسوله وعلماء المسلمين قال الله تعالى وما أمروا إلا ليعبدوا الله مخلصين له الدين الآية وقال حنبل سمعت أبا عبد الله أحمد بن محمد بن حنبل يقول من قال هذا فقد كفر بالله ورد على أمره وعلى الرسول وما جاء به عن الله. Ibn Taymiyyah mentions here that Humaydiyu said, أخبرتُ, I was informed and I was told that a group of people are saying anyone who testifies, he believes only, that's it. He testifies and he acknowledges, he affirms the salah. He says, yes, salah is wajib. I believe that. والزكاه, zakat I also believe is wajib. والصوم, and I also believe fasting is obligatory. والحج, and hajj is also obligatory. ولم يفعل من ذلك شيئا, but he doesn't do any of them. I just say that he affirms the wujub, but he doesn't do any of them. حتى يموت, until he dies. ويصلي مستدبر القبلة, and he prays facing away from the qibla. حتى يموت, until he dies. Okay, فهو مؤمن. A group of people are saying those people are believers, as long as they're not jahid, as long as they're not doing it out of stubbornness and rejecting the ruling, as long as they're not doing it out of that. إذا علم أن تركه ذلك فيه إيمانه إذا كان مقرا بالفرائض واستقبال القبلة. As long as his leaving of this is not due to him not affirming the obligation, and also acknowledging that. When Humaydi was told that there's a group of people saying that, he says, هذا الكفر الصراح. That's clear cut kufr. It's not just kufr. It's a clear cut kufr. وقلاف, and it is opposed, it's an opposition to what? The Kitabullah, Allah's Kitab. وسنة رسولي, and the Sunnah of the Messenger. وعلماء المسلمين. He's talking about the Salaf. قال الله تعالى, Allah says, he says, وما أمروا إلا ليعبدوا الله مخلصين له الدين. الآية. Then Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah brings the statement of who? Hanbal, who said, سمعت أبي عبد الله أحمد بن حنبل. Hanbal ibn Ishaq, his name is. He said, I heard Ahmad ibn Hanbal saying, من قال هذا, anyone who says that, فقد كفر بالله, has disbelieved in Allah. ورد على أمره, and he's rejected the command of Allah. وعلى الرسول, and on the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, in what? ما جاء به عن الله, that which he has come. That which he has come with from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the author says, وَإِمَانُنَا قَوْلٌ وَفِعْلٌ وَنِيَّةٌ مِنَ الْخَيْرِ. This is a jar and a majroor. The mean is harfu jar. And al-khayri is what? An ism majroor. The jar and the majroor are both connected to فِيمَا سَبَقَ ذِكْرُهُ. That which has previously been mentioned. Which is what? That our iman is speech which is good. And actions which are good. And intentions which are good. So that's where the word good enters. The word here, al-khayr, min al-khayri, the jar and the majroor is connected to what? That which has just been recently mentioned, which is wa imanuna qawlun, speeches, wa fi'lun, and actions, wa niyyatun. So it enters aqwalul khayri wa a'malul khayri والنيات الخيرات الصالحات. That is what iman is to us. والطاعات فيها نقيد. And the طاعات فيها, in it, this ضمير, the word فيها, this pronoun ها, it goes and refers back to the intentions. And what the author is trying to say here is that every action is accepted. But it's accepted based on what? To Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, as long as the intention is good. As long as the person is doing this this action on the intention of obedience. If he's doing it because everybody else does it, that intention is not based on ta'a. That's why he's saying, وَالطَّاعَاتِ فِيهَا نُقَيِّدُ. We restrict the intention. فِيهَا أي, the intention. We restrict it. Nuqayyud means we restrict it to obedience. It's not just any intentions that you come with. The intention here has to be, why are you praying for? Are you praying because everybody else is praying? It's not accepted then. But what we restrict the intention to is that you're doing it out of obedience. I'm a slave. The master commanded me and I am following the command of the master, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. That's why you have to do it. If you're doing it for other worldly gains, the salah won't be accepted from you. That's why Allah said in the Quran, وَمَنْ أَرَادَ الْآخِرَةَ وَسَعَى لَهَا سَعْيَهَا وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ فَأُولَٰئِكَ كَانَ سَعْيُهُمْ مَشْكُورًا. If the person is doing this and he's striving for it for a hereafter gain, he wants Jannah and for it, he's doing it because of obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whilst in a state of belief, Allah then says, فَأُولَٰئِكَ كَانَ سَعْيُهُمْ مَشْكُورًا. Those are the ones who is striving is praiseworthy, whose efforts don't go to waste. They don't go to vain. So that's what the author means. وَالطَّاعَاتِ فِيهَا أَيْ فِي النِّيَّاتِ نُقَيِّدُ. We restrict it. That's what he means. نعم.
وَيَزْدَادُ بِالطَّاعَةِ مَعْ تَرْكِ مَا نَهَى وَيَنْقُصُ بِالْعِصْيَانِ جَزْمًا وَيَفْسُدُ.
It increases with acts of obedience while refraining from what he forbade, and decreases by disobedience, with all certainty, and is corrupted.
The author here says, وَيَزْدَادُ بِالطَّاعَةِ. The word وَيَزْدَادُ أي الإيمان. The iman is the one that increases. What it increases with is obedience. Your iman increases. And you know why it increases? It increases with obedience. Every time the person increases in acts of obedience, and he comes with it, زَادَ إِيمَانُهُ, his iman increases. And every time that the person comes with sins and that which Allah has prohibited, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the iman, it decreases. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us that, he said, al-imanu bid'un wa sab'una shu'bah, afdaluha qawlu la ilaha illallah, wa adnaha imatatul adha anil tariq, wal haya'u shu'batun min al-iman. The hadith is Sahih Muslim, this wording, which is that iman is of different branches. It's of what? Bid'un wa sab'una, 70 and odd branches. The greatest and the most virtuous one of them is what? The statement of La ilaha illallah. The lowest of it is what? Taking harm from the path, taking harm from the road. And then the Prophet says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Wal haya'u shu'batu min al-iman. And shyness is a branch of iman. It's a branch of al-iman. So what this hadith shows us is that the branches of al-iman are many. It's not one, it's not two, it's not three, it's many. So every single time some people are doing imatatul adha anit tariq. They are doing the lowest branches of al-iman. So their iman is not going to be of the caliber of a person whose iman is what? Is of the highest branch. So this hadith shows us it. And that's why the author says, the iman, it increases with obedience whilst leaving that which you have been prohibited from. So the iman increases with what? Obedience. Whilst the person is staying away from that which is prohibited. Because some people think, oh, I'm doing active obedience, but my iman is not increasing. But you're doing things that are going against the acts of obedience that you're coming with. Are you with me? It's like a person who is pouring water into a cup, but the cup is what? Broken. It's cracked, or a glass, or even a bottle, and it's pissed. There's a hole in the bottle. So you're pouring in, but it's going out. So when the person is doing acts of obedience, they have to stay away from that which they are prohibited from. And that's why the Prophet ﷺ, he says, مِنْ حُسْنِ إِسْلَامِ الْمَرْءِ تَرْكُ مَا لَا يَعْنِي. From the goodness of one's Islam is what? That he leaves off that which does not concern him. So if that is something that is what? That doesn't concern you, it shows the goodness of your Islam. How about if the thing is haram? This is just ما لا يعني. This is something that doesn't concern you really. Doesn't necessarily have to be haram. But imagine if those things are haram, your iman is definitely going to be of great. Also, the Prophet ﷺ tells us, "La yazni zani hina yazni wa huwa mu'min, wa la yashrabu al-khamru hina yashrabu ha wa huwa mu'min, wa la yasriqu as-sariqu hina yasriqu wa huwa mu'min." That the Prophet told us that the person does not do zina whilst he's doing zina in a state of iman. And the person does not drink khamar when he drinks khamar in a state of iman. And the person does not steal when he steals in a state of iman. And what that means is that his true complete iman is not there whilst he's doing this action. So from the hadith we can take the mafhumul mukhalafa is that if the person stays away from these things, what happens? He has true iman. Sahih? If this is saying that with this that your iman won't be there, or the completeness of your iman won't be there, it means that if I stay away from it and I don't do it, my iman will be there and it will be incomplete. It will be complete. It will be complete. وَيَنْقُصُ بِالْعِصْيَانِ The Sheikh says, it decreases with disobedience, jazman. Here, jazman means what? يَقِينًا. With certainty. حَقًّا. لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ There's no doubt about it. That the sins reduce the iman. And that the person's iman becomes affected by it. ولذلك it was narrated from Umayr ibn Habib al-Khutami as Abu Bakr al-Khalal narrated in his kitab al-Sunnah that he said al-Iman yazid wa yanqus, that the Iman increases and it decreases. قِيلَ مَا زِيَادَتُهُ, he was asked, what is it that increases it? وَنُقْصَانُهُ, and what is it that reduces it? قَالَ, he says, إِذَا ذَكَرْنَا اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ, if we remember Allah, وَحَمِدْنَاهُ, and we praise Him, وَسَبَّحْنَاهُ, and we exalt Him, فَتِلْكَ زِيَادَتُهُ, with that increases. وَإِذَا أَغْفَلْنَا, if we are heedless of Him, وَضَيَّعْنَا, and we forsake, وَأَسَأْنَا, and we become sinners and come with shortcomings, فَذَاكَ نُخْصَانُهُ, with that it reduces. Then the author goes on to say, وَيَفْسُدُ, and if the person's sins increase on more, what does that do? It actually destroys his iman. It corrupts his iman. It eats through his iman. وَلِذَلِكَ, that's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us, لَا تَحْقِرَنَّ مِنَ الْمَعْرُوفِ شَيْئًا, don't ever belittle a righteous deed. Even if it means, وَأَن تَلْقَ أَخَاكَ بِوَجْهٍ طَلَقْ, even if it means to meet your brother with a smiley face. And the ulama took from this, do not also belittle the sins. They say, لِأَنَّ الْجِبَالَ مِنَ الْحَصَى, because the mountain that you see in front of you is made out of pebbles. And it is from those small sins, those small little things that you belittle and you see as, that actually come together and make a person leave the religion. It was a sin that you belittled, that ate through your iman, and it reduced your iman. And then you did another small sin over there that you thought, okay, wasn't that big. But when they do come together, what happens? And that's why the Prophet ﷺ said, there is a group of people come together, and everybody brings a twig with fire, or he brings a, my fire may alone not be able to do much. But if we all bring our, what happens? It fires, it burns a place. We can have nice. If everybody look, for example, we say today, you know, we're fasting, let's go and make iftar. You know what, you make chicken, you make lamb, you make this, you make this, you make this. And everybody brings it to the table. Are we going to have a big iftar? We're going to have a big iftar? Nah. So with the small things that come together, they become big. So when the sins come together, they become big. And at that time, the person reaches a point where in reality, it's hard for him to come back. He leaves the religion. He doesn't want to hear about it. The problem isn't now. It was how it was building up. ولذلك, the Prophet said, إِذَا أَذْنَبَ عَبْدِي ذَنْبًا نُكِتَتْ فِي قَلْبِهِ نُكْتَةً سَوْدًا. Whenever the person commits a sin, a black dot is placed in his heart. The Prophet said, فَإِنْ تَابَ وَأَنَابَ, if the person repents, comes back to his senses, realize what he's done is wrong, and he asks Allah for forgiveness, his heart is getting made clean, it's made white, and everything goes back to normal. And if he doesn't, the Prophet told us, alayhi salatu wasalam, what happens? His heart becomes tainted and black. And that's where the Prophet recited the ayah, كَلَّا بَلْ رَانَ عَلَى قُلُوبِهِ مَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ, with the people's heart, it became black and darkened through what? Through the sins that they've done. Allah says in the Quran, فَلَمَّا زَاغُوا أزاغ الله قلوبهم, when they deviated. So look, they turned slightly. They belittled a sin. Allah then says, فلما زاغوا أزاغ الله قلوبهم. Allah says in another ayah, ونقلب أفئدتهم وأبصارهم كما لم يؤمنوا به أول مرة. It's one ruling that you may belittle from the Quran and the Sunnah and say, look, I don't care. I'm doing all of this. But you're belittling this.